Libby Schaaf, welcome and congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Did you come here on your fire-breathing snail, by the way?
No. I left the snail back in Oakland, where the snail belongs.
Hard to get over the bridge. What do you think the voters were looking for? What did they see in you that they didn't see, for example, in the incumbent, Mayor Kwan? What are they looking for?
You know, I think they're looking for someone who's going to take Oakland to the next level, who's going to provide some very clear but honest communications about what is happening in Oakland City government and what we need to do to solve some of our problems and lift up some of our greatness.
What are the priorities?
Number one priority is public safety. That is something that Oakland has struggled with for a long time, and it's the most basic service that people deserve. Oaklanders need to feel confident that a cop will come when they call. They need to feel like their city is safe, and we need to make sure the rest of the world sees Oakland as a safe, vibrant, exciting city.
It's so basic, public safety, that feeling of security. Why has it been so difficult to deliver? Is it just a shortage of police officers?
You know, public safety has been a struggle for Oakland my whole life. And as you know, I am born and raised in Oakland. I have lived in this city all my life. And so it is not a new struggle for Oakland. But we now have examples of other cities that have become incredibly safer. Los Angeles is a great example for me. 81% reduction in crime. That's what I want for Oakland.
And what do you think you can adapt? Like, how are you going to be going about that? Does the city need a new police chief, for example?
I'm a big believer in community-based policing, better utilization of data, proactive problem-solving policing, and also recognizing that policing is not the totality of the public safety equation. We have got to invest in successful intervention and prevention programs. I'm a supporter of the ceasefire approach, and we have to address those root causes of crime. That's jobs, better wages, and particularly for me, better educational outcomes for all of Oakland's children.
We're seeing here in San Francisco a real boom in the economy with tech in particular, but the downside is affordability. People are being forced out of San Francisco. Many of them are going to Oakland, where housing prices are going up as well. How are you going to deal with that balance of keeping a middle class, a vibrant middle class, artists and others who don't have a lot of money, but who are such an integral part of the fabric of a successful city?
I am so excited about growing Oakland, revitalizing it, welcoming new residents, but absolutely not at the expense of our existing residents, nor selling our soul. You know, that.
What does that mean?
That secret DNA that makes Oakland, Oakland. It's diversity, it's artists, and it's blue-collar, working-class neighborhoods and jobs.
But San Francisco wanted to do that, too, but it's so many people fear that it's losing.
But our advantage is we are physically twice the size of San Francisco, and we are starting out with half the population. The other mistake that San Francisco made is we are going to be much more aggressive about building new housing so that we can relieve that pressure on our existing housing stock. We have got to stabilize housing prices, and then we've got to use some creative policies that allow affordability to be created where people are already living, as opposed to so much focus on building new affordable buildings.
You got a big endorsement in the final weeks of the campaign from someone you used to work for, Jerry Brown. You worked for him when he was mayor. What advice did he give you? What did you learn from him?
You know, I learned that you have to prioritize, that you cannot be all things to all people, that a mayor needs to set clear priorities and then move the entire organization around executing those priorities.
What do you think you won't be able to do that people may want you to do in these 4 years?
Many, many things.
Like?
Well, you know, I will address all of the quality of life issues, but my focus as mayor is going to be on public safety. Now, I'm going to hire an incredible city administrator, and that individual is responsible, and those department heads are responsible for providing excellent service in all areas of the city. One of my priorities is going to be to retool service delivery and inject an accountability and transparency system in the city of Oakland that hopefully will benefit everybody's agendas.
There's a sense among some people who live in Oakland that the basics of city services just haven't been there, whether it's, you know, cleaning the streets, paving the streets. How big a concern of yours is that going to be?
It was a big priority in my campaign. I talked a lot about changing the way that we deliver services because our city has got to look cleaner. It does not look the way it deserves to look, because we know Oakland is so beautiful. It's full of great architecture, natural beauty. We've got that lake in the middle of our city. We've got incredible parks. But those parks need to be kept clean. They need to be manicured. They need to not have graffiti on their structures. That's incredibly important. And we need to change the way that we deliver services and hold city workers accountable, but also involve city workers in changing the system so that we see better results.
Just a few seconds left. How are you going to evaluate the job you did in your first 4 years?
I believe in having metrics and using data to measure performance. I'm going to work with all the stakeholders in Oakland to establish what those goals are going to be, and I'm going to measure them every day.
All right, Libby Schaaf, congratulations
Thank
again,
you.
And good
Thanks
luck.
Thanks so much.
All right.
Really appreciate
you
being here.